Hello and welcome back to Travel in Chinese. I'm Mark Rosewell, also known as Dash N. We're talking about traveling in China, but actually the language we're learning in this series can be used in a wide variety of situations. We're trying to reach as wide an audience as possible, so whether you're a beginner or an advanced learner, we hope that you'll pick up something from these lessons. Of course, we do go through the lessons relatively quickly, but every once in a while, we stop and we review the lessons that we've covered in the previous few weeks, and that's what we're going to do today. Today, we're going to review some of the lessons where Xue Mei was touring around Zhejiang Province, Hangzhou. This is a beautiful city on the banks of the West Lake, Xihu, and one of the ancient capitals of China. Then, in the following lessons, Huang Renhao is in Inner Mongolia with his daughter, Xiao Jie. From lakes and canals to grasslands and desert, it's quite a contrast in today's episode. Well, Hangzhou is probably one of the most beautiful cities in China. Even then, Xue Mei says it's 简直难以置信, simply hard to believe. 简直不可能 would be simply impossible. 置信 is to believe, but this term is often used in the negative sense, as in 难以置信, it's hard to believe, or 不可置信, it's unbelievable. Over and over we hear the phrase 上有天堂,下有苏杭, above there's heaven and below there are Suzhou and Hangzhou. In other words, this general area is known by combining the two city names into 苏杭, heaven on earth. The two cities are linked by the remains of a grand canal, the Da Yunhe, that once stretched all the way north to Beijing. Both are part of the same Jiangnan region of China. That's the lower reaches of the Yangtze River. And some say West Lake is like a beautiful woman, 美女. Xue Mei exclaims, 果然如此, it really is true. 果然 indicates, as expected, 如此, this way, what I've heard is true. Do you remember in a previous lesson the expression, 果然, 名不虚传, as expected, the reputation is well deserved. Okay, well, there's a lot of material that we could talk about in detail, but why don't we just go straight to the dialogue and watch it for ourselves.
哎呀,我们到了,这里就是西湖了。真漂亮,简直让人难以置信。那当然,不是说上有天堂,下有苏杭吗?有人说西湖就像个美女,果然如此。
我呀,真的是非常喜欢这个地方,我都来这三次了。哎,你们看,那边有租船的,咱们也租一条,坐船游西湖吧。好啊,走。西湖的景色真是名不虚传,处处是景啊。就是,如果我们再晚来一个月的话,我们就能看到平湖秋月了。哎,那不是西湖十景之一吗?那西湖十景你一定都看过吧?说来遗憾。
我每次啊，差不多都是这个时候来，西湖十景一直没有看全。西湖十景跟时间有关系吗？可不是，断桥残雪呀，就一定得在冬天看，而平湖秋月呢，就只能在秋天才能看到了。哦，这样一来，西湖十景想要看全，未免太难了。哎，你们来看，那条堤坝呀，那就是苏堤了。
哦，那就是苏堤啊。 我看书上介绍过,说是一个很有名的人修的。没错,是宋朝的大诗人苏轼主持修建的。
In the next lesson, we did one of those must-do things when you go to Hangzhou. We went out for some special green tea, 绿茶, known as 龙井 tea, 龙井茶. We used a language pattern learned in an earlier lesson, that is, 边 something else, to do one thing while doing another, to do two things at once. For instance, 边品茶边看风景, to drink tea while watching the scenery or enjoying the scenery. Now, 品 is to taste, to sample food or drink, as in 品尝. 品茶 sounds much more refined and civilized than simply 喝茶. Since the Ming Dynasty hundreds of years ago, Longjing has been considered one of the best Chinese teas, one of the 上品, one of the best products. The opposite, a 次品, would be the defective or a second-class product, 次品. Now, poets have even described Longjing tea as being 黄金芽, gold sprouts, since the tea is made from the freshest tea leaves. But where did the name Dragon Well Tea, 龙井茶, come from? There are several different theories about that. 有说是井名, some say it was the name of a well, others say it was 寺名, the name of a temple, or even 村名, the name of a village. Somewhat like with wine, the quality of a tea depends a lot on when the tea is harvested. For example, Chun Cha, the first tea of the spring, yields the smallest quantity, but the most precious teas. Now, the best teas should be Se Lu, green in color, Xiang Yu, lush in fragrance, Wei Pu, simple in flavor, and Xing Mei, beautiful in appearance. And one of the ways you can tell a good Longjing tea is the way the tea leaves stand up at the bottom of the glass or teacup. 一根根竖着, they stand vertically, one by one. One of the best ways to enjoy tea is through the tea ceremony, 茶艺表演. Okay, let's go back and watch that dialogue again.
这是我喝过的最好的龙井，姐妹味道怎么样？很好喝，嘿，新湖的龙井是不是很有名？可不是，在明代的时候啊，龙井茶就已经成为茶中的上品了，算起来有好几百年历史了吧？
嗯，你知道吗，雪梅？中国古代有的诗人把龙井称为黄金崖呢，可见龙井有多受人们欢迎。
龙井是个地名吗？
这个问题比较复杂。
有说是井名，有说是村民和寺名的。那什么样的茶才算是好的龙井茶呢？我听说龙井茶按采摘的季节，大致可以分为春茶、二茶和三茶。春茶产量少，所以特别珍贵。你说是吧？是这样的，茶叶的采摘季节固然重要，不过龙井的品质和茶叶的形状、色泽也有很大关系。上好的龙井应该是色绿。
香芋、味醇、形美。哎，你们看，这茶叶都是一根根竖着，真有意思。我看这儿的服务员还可以进行茶艺表演呢，我们也该看看来吧。好。Our
lessons then skipped all the way from Hangzhou in the eastern part of China to Inner Mongolia, Neimenggu in the north. The term Neimeng is used to distinguish this region of China from Waimeng, Outer Mongolia, which is a separate country, often called Mengguguo, the Republic of Mongolia. Inner Mongolia is a region of China that borders on the Republic of Mongolia. This area is best known for the vast grasslands, 草原. Xiaojie sees a number of white houses, but these are not ordinary 房子. 那样的房子叫蒙古包. That kind of house is called a Mongolian yurt, also called a gur. A yurt is a round, felt-covered tent that traditionally has been used by Mongolian nomads. In Chinese, we use the term bao to describe this kind of tent. Xiaojie wonders if it has anything to do with baozi, the steamed dumplings, baozi. 是倒是一个字, it actually is the same character. 不过这意思就完全不一样了, but the meaning is completely different. 是倒是 is a pattern we learned in this lesson. It's used to concede a point. Yes, it is the same character, but 不过, it has a completely different meaning. We could use this structure to say something like 便宜倒是便宜,但质量有问题. Yes, it is inexpensive, but the quality is questionable. In the dialogue, Huang Renhao explains that there are bao. The bao character comes from the Manchurian language 满语. It means home or room. After all, Mengguguo, a Mongolian yurt, is the traditional home used by Mongolians. Okay, well, there's a lot of material that we could talk about in detail, but why don't we just go straight to the dialogue and watch it for ourselves.
好看吧，我在那边采的。
真好看，小杰啊，草原好玩吧？
好玩，这儿又大又漂亮，还有那么多的花儿。爸爸，你闻闻，很香啊。
是香。
我们就别回家，就住在这儿吧。
啊？要是我们住在这儿，你不想你妈妈呀？
我们可以把妈妈接到这儿来，和我们一起住啊。然后盖一间大房子。
嗯，那你想盖一间什么样的房子呀？
哎，我看那边有很多白色的房子，我们也可以盖一间那样的房子啊。
白色的房子？哈，这样的房子呀，应该叫蒙古包。
蒙古包，包是包子的包吗？
哈哈哈，是倒是一个字，不过呀，这意思可就完全不一样了。这里的包啊，是满语，是家和室的意思。
我明白了，蒙古包就是蒙古人的家，纳乌和浩特的意思就是蒙古的城市了。
你真聪明，不过呀，浩特不是满语，是蒙语，是城市的意思。
真好玩，爸爸，我想看看蒙古包里边是什么样的。
爸爸有一个朋友啊，就住在前面蒙古包里，走，我带你看看去。
太好了。
It seems Xiao Jie wants to move her whole family to Mongolia and build a house on the grasslands. She's enthralled with the Mengu Bao, Mongolian yurts. In the next lesson, they get a chance to visit inside a yurt. As is the custom, they're offered a traditional Mongolian drink called Nai Cha, literally milk tea. Well, Nai Cha is not just tea with milk, it's also quite salty. 怎么是咸的? How could it be salty? Huan Renhao explains that this kind of tea is also called Zhuan Cha, brick tea.蒙古族的砖茶, this is Mongolian brick tea. 蒙古族 refers to the Mongolian ethnic group, one of the 5 minority groups in China. The tea is compacted into brick shapes. To make this tea, you boil the water, then slowly stew the tea, 慢慢熬, and then finally you add some table salt. 小姐 isn't sure she could make it. 我可做不出来. I couldn't do it. I couldn't make it. Here, 可 merely adds emphasis.The pattern of verb plus 不出来 is one that we talked about before, to show that an action can't be completed. 我做不出来, I can't make it. This is a very useful term and a useful verb ending. Traditionally, Mongolians have been a nomadic people, moving from place to place over the different seasons. Of course, the horse is central to this traditional lifestyle. As a friend explains, 如果不会骑马,那可就算不上一个真正的蒙古人。If you can't ride a horse, you can't be considered a real Mongolian. Here, 算 means to be considered or perhaps to be counted as one. 算不上 can't be considered. For example, 这个算不上好的. This can't be considered a good one. It turns out their friend is no ordinary horseman. Back in his youth, he'd won the championship in the Nadam horse races. Okay, well, there's a lot of material that we could talk about in detail, but why don't we just go straight to the dialogue and watch it for ourselves?
小姐渴了吧？尝尝叔叔家的奶茶好喝不好喝？
哎，怎么是咸的？爸爸，我以前从来都没喝过这样的茶。
好喝吗？
挺香的。叔叔，你是怎么泡的？告诉我，等我回家以后泡给我妈妈喝，让她也尝一尝。
小杰啊，叔叔家的茶可不是泡的，是熬出来的。
熬出来的？那不是成熬汤了吗？
不是那么回事儿，奶茶呀，是用这种特殊的茶叶煮出来的。
哇，这么厚，看起来像砖一样。
对，这呀就是蒙古族的砖茶，把这样的茶叶呀放在锅里煮，然后呢放上鲜奶，再慢慢的熬，最后啊加入盐巴，才能做出这样的奶茶呢。我说的对吧？
对对对，
这么复杂，我可做不出来。叔叔，我刚才进来的时候看见门口有马，是您的吗？
是啊。
那您会骑吗？
叔叔当然会骑了。小杰啊，在这儿如果不会骑马，那可就算不上一个真正的蒙古人了。
That brings us to the end of the review lesson. Hope you're able to pick up more the second time through. In our next episode, we're going to start a whole series of new material.We're heading further west into the region called Xinjiang. This is a very unique part of China and traditionally has been a blending point for Chinese and cultures to the west of China as part of the Silk Road, which ran straight through Xinjiang. Now, if you have any comments or suggestions for our program, we hope you'll contact us at the information on the screen. And we hope to see you next time here at Travel in Chinese. Until then, 再见.